Hi, so I have a lot of questions on my AC setup in this van. I'm running it fully off of solar power. A lot of people say that it can't be done and you have to be plugged into shore power, but it's very possible because we have it right here. Here, come along to the side. I'll show you what it is on the outside. It's a window AC unit like you'd have in your home. And all that's on the outside is just this grill that I put over it. Then here, let me take you down underneath the van and show you where the air comes in. You can see that little grate right there that I put on the bottom sets the air intake for the condenser, and then it comes out right there. And I'll show you what's on top of the van. The solar panels actually have four 320 watt some power monocrystalline panels up here. Now, with those panels added together with all four of them, you'd be at 1280 watts. However, that's the standard test condition. So that's like super nominal laboratory, you know, wattage there. So I have a nominal operating cell temperature rating on them, which is 238 watts each. So four of those would be like 950 watts about. And I think that's more along the lines of what I'm getting with these. With these monocrystalline panels, they're super efficient. They're at 19.6% efficiency, where the flexible stick-on panels that a lot of people in van life go with, those things have like 7 to 13% efficiency. So really, these are the way to go if you can fit them on your van. These are 61 inches wide, so they're definitely bigger, but they work really well for what I need. Come on in, I'll show you the AC unit. So you can see it's a 6,000 BTU Toshiba unit right here. Digital temperature, all of that. It also comes with the remote, which is nice. Sleep timer, you know, a lot of the standard things that you want. Now, some of the issues that I noticed having this where it's at, just things that I've learned having, you know, doing van life with it for a little bit. Having it on the ground is fine for the air intake, that's a-okay, but the vents don't really go that high up. It's cool air, so it naturally wants to sink. And I actually had to sand out some of the, they had little stoppers that kept it going maybe about right there. So it was shooting out like that. I sanded those off and now it goes a little bit higher, but it's still, I don't know. I wish I would have got something where I could have put ducting in and up out the side. You'll also see since I sanded off the little stopper that it doesn't want to hold itself up a lot of the time. So I'll wedge in a piece of paper or a ruler down underneath. It does put out a lot of cold air, but it depends what kind of van you have and how many windows you have. This is a passenger van, so it has a ton of windows. I've locked off the rear side windows, but I still have the two back windows, the two on the side here, two on the side here, giant windshield, and the two front windows. So it very quickly turns into a solar oven inside of here. This does pretty good at keeping the temperatures down. But like I said, with the airflow not being fully dispersed, this little fan does a lot of good favors. We plug this in, put it down, and then it really helps circulate the cool air a little bit better. Now with this AC unit, I mentioned the amount of watts that I have up there for solar, the nominal, you know, the real world operating condition, like 950 watts of solar. This 600 BTU unit, you can pick it up for about $200, and it pulls 536 watts is what it's rated for. Now with the power inverter, I have a cheap Chinese off-brand power inverter. You probably estimate the efficiency around like 85%, 85 to 90%. And with that, you'd probably be pulling around 615 watts realistically off of your battery setup. So that's just under 50 amps at 12 or 13 volts. And then, you know, people also think that the fridge is gonna pull a lot of power. I do have the fridge in here. It's a 3.1 cubic foot fridge and air fridge freezer combo. But really, this only pulls around 120 watts. It works really great for us. Neither of these compressors are made for van life or to be bounced around, but we've been down some very bumpy roads and off-roading with both of them, and they both still seem to work okay. If anything happens to them, like I said, this is a $200 unit. The, you know, proper van life ones made for going off-road, those you're looking in the thousands. So if this thing does fail, I'll pull it out, pick up a new one, and I'll still be very far ahead. The fridge itself, like I said, it works for what we do. Only pulls around 120 watts, and with the, you know, 85%, 90% efficiency of the power inverter, maybe 140 watts. And for reference, the 3.1 cubic feet is around 88 liters, I believe, because I know some of the other brands like to measure theirs in liters. Here, I'll show you what's going on with my battery setup and my solar charge controller and inverter. So down inside of this cabinet is where I have a collection of line corks. And there's the solar charge controller. And it's a little cloudy out right now, but you can still see that I'm sitting around 12.6 volts. And once the clouds go away, it shoots back up to around 600, 700 watts coming in. The power inverter right here, it's just a weird off-brand. The output voltage indicator is burnt out now. And another thing that I would do differently on my next build, not use the solid copper core wire. That's Romex wire there. You really want to use stranded, I learned, for van life, just because it bounces around so much. You want something that's flexible, where solid copper, if it bounces around too much, it will break. Now, with this setup, I have it mounted and tacked on in so many locations, it really doesn't have an opportunity to bounce around, but I'd still just go with stranded instead in the future. For the battery setup, again, these are, you know, they're mix and matched. It's, I know you're supposed to go with one brand and stick with it. They are all AGM batteries. Here I have a 200 amp hour Renogy deep cycle battery. Down there I have a deep cycle AGM Optima battery that's 60 amp hours. And then way in the back underneath the bed, I also have a fused 100 amp hour Odyssey deep cycle marine battery. So total, I guess you would say, would be 360 amp hours, but realistically the Optima and the Odyssey battery back there are used, so I might be at possibly 300 amp hours. But okay, you can see the sun's coming out again. We're going right back up there in the solar. So yeah, I can run this AC unit, you know, non-stop. Realistically, I can keep this thing running all day without having any issues or any drop in voltage, and it works great. I also have the Victron 120 amp battery combiner back there, so when my voltage is up, like right now it's 12.72 volts, the solar is actually charging my van starting battery. And it also works the other way, so if the van is running and there's 14.4 volts coming off of the alternator, it'll use the solar and the alternator at the same time to charge my house batteries back here. So hopefully that's a pretty good overview of what I have going on for the AC in the van. I'll give you a couple of my regrets with it, some of the things that I really like about it, but more than anything, just show you that it is totally possible to have AC off the grid. Thanks for watching.